Yeah, you will get after doing the basic storage, you are getting the storage device below me, contain data. So you can do this, yes, discard any data. It means what partition size you are given enough in starting. You, like you have provided 20 GB. So it is going to format that partition size of the 20 GB only. It is examining of the storage, checking the storage device. Here now you can see you are getting host name. If you want to change, you can change from here, but it necessary if you are going to change. So instead of local host dot local domain, you have to use, like I am going to use like Deepak. So it will be a Deepak dot Deepak like this. You have to do like dot in between the host name and domain. So I am just renaming, like I am just leaving it the same. I am not changing anything over here. But directly you can change it. If you want to change, you can change it. Now here you can select your country or clock. So I'm in India, so I'm choosing Kolkata, and next. Now here you can set the root password. It is a root one, so I'm going to set a root password. It is a root. Now next, it is a password. The password root must be at least 6 character long. Okay. So we have to provide at least 6 character of the password for the installation. So red hat. Now we can select next. It like weak password. It is showing you the pop-up for the weak password. You have provided a weak password. Like I have used red hat only password. So use anyway if you are providing like this type of the password. So use anyway. Otherwise if you have any strong password, so this pop-up you will not get. Use anyway. Next. Now here you are getting this type of the screen. Again you have to choose here. Create custom layout. Like you will be create your partition by your own. Select next. After this, you are getting like this type of this screen. This is called sudo partition. Sorry, dude partition disk. It is a dude partition disk. From here, you are creating a partition. So it is a free size of the partition. I have 20 GB. So I am going to simply click here create. So I am going to create 7 partition. So it will be a standard partition size. Partition type will be standard. Now create. And then use mount point. So first of all, I am going to use slash partition, and the size of the slash partition I am providing 4 GB, 4096. Okay. Next partition I am going to create. Simply you can create from here. Click on create standard partition, create mount point. What is your boot? Boot is a 256 MB booting partition. It is a need for 256 MB. So okay, from here, next partition. I'm going to create again next partition. Create standard partition mount point. Now I'm going to create home partition, and home partition size I'm going to provide 2 GB only. 2048. Okay. Again, I'm going to create new partition. It will be a standard. Again, create. Now here mount point will be temp. again temp partition, I'm going to provide the 2 GB of the hard disk 2048. Now again create new partition, standard create mount point. Now here where, and now where partition size 2048 2 GB. Now I have to create USR partition. This is my second last partition. Partition will be USR local. This partition size minimum 4 GB I am providing. So it will be a 4096. It is a MB4096. It will convert into the GB. So I have created 6 of the partition. Now last partition will be swap area. So I am going to create same standard create. Now here, instead of mount point, you have to select file system type. So you can create, select here, please wait. I'm not getting. So after clicking over here, you can use drop down, like I'm using arrow key. So I'm getting here swap. So this is a swap, and the size of the swap, it will be dual of the RAM. So in future I'll decrease the RAM size. So I'm just providing 2048, which is a 2 GB, and simply okay. So I have now created 7 partition, 3 and 4 7, and now I have to select next. Remaining free space, leave it. When I'll show you the video how we can create the partition in a command line. So on that time it will be work, it will be useful. So next, now here it is showing, do you want to format this? So yes, simply format, write change to disk. Now it will take some time. It is going to format all the partition you have created earlier. After the formatting all the partition you are getting from your install boot or bootloader on DAV, it's your driver name DEVSDA. So use this, simply click on next. Don't do anything over here. Simply click on next. Now your Fedora operating system, Fedora version 17, is installing in a hard drive. So it will take some time. So please wait for some time. You can relax. It will like take 5 to 10 minutes. So you have to relax for that time. Now your installation is done. Here you can see it is asking for the reboot. Now you can simply reboot the machine. So I am rebooting the machine. Here you can see this is Fedora booting. Now your Fedora operating system is booting now. So after booting you will get the screen for the Fedora. Please wait. This is booting. Here after booting you will get like this, welcome. Simply forward it, license forward it. Here create a user, you can create it, otherwise you can choose it later. So I'm going to create just because I'll show you how to give the root access after that installation. Simply click here forward. After filling all the forms like username, like full name, username, confirm password, forward, simply forward, date time, leave it forward. Now last one is a hardware profile. It's finished over here. Don't do anything. Finish directly. Do not sign. Now it is forwarding your system.